Sagittarius friends, and welcome to your horoscope for June of 2020, where this month, Sag, there is going to be some shift going down for sure. We have got 60% of our planets that will be moving in retrograde fashion. Venus does come back in bounds this month, but Mercury continues at the beginning of the month out of bounds, which means that you're still looking outside of your normal circles for the first few weeks of this month for information that you're gathering to make changes, to apply solutions in your life, and just for everything, really. But then we also have two eclipses happening this month, and the first one is in your sign. So this is an energy of redefinition over the next 6 months, and it's neat because it's not really optional, right? Like, the light is shown so big on you at this particular time, and it's like, okay, let's make some course corrections. And that does not mean anything negative. It just means this is a season of change for sure. But with 60% of the planets in retrograde this month, Sagittarius, you have plenty of time to stop and look around and say, okay, how would I like to present myself? How would I like this to look? How would I like to show this? It is a wonderful, wonderful energy for figuring out what's next. So let's jump in here and talk about what's happening this month, okay? Right at the beginning of the month, on the 2nd, we're going to see Mercury moving into its shadow time right before it takes its retrograde in the energy of Cancer. Now, this is going to light up your 8th house, but what you want to know about the shadow period is that, first of all, Mercury is still out of bounds. So we're thinking, we're speaking, our emotions may feel a little outside of their normal comfort zone, you know, but outside of the comfort zone is where you get the honest exploration of what's next. So as Mercury comes into the shadow and begins to slow down, you may notice things in the 8th house slow down for you. Maybe a partner's money slows down, or a partnership, or a collaboration, or someplace where you were kind of investing intimately feels like it's slowed down a little bit. And that's okay. Just know that Mercury's getting set to shift around, okay? On the 5th is when we're going to have this full moon lunar eclipse in your sign. Now, this is the big deal of the month. This kicks you off for the next 6 months. The full moon says that something needs to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted, but because it's an eclipse, it is literally a resetting of your emotions. And again, this is going to be about your perceptions of you, how you would like to be received and perceived. Does your reputation come around the corner before you, and what does it say about you? I have to tell you, as I record this today, it's actually at the full moon happening in Scorpio. And what I keep sensing for you, Sag, is that it's not just the wardrobe situation is changing, but truly, I feel like because so much is happening in the 8th house for you this month as well, you may be having a full redefinition that literally comes from an acknowledgement of your sexuality or your healing or something that is set very much so in one of these base chakras, which is like, what is Sagittarius standing on? What is Sagittarius standing for? It's this energy where it is like, you're literally coming out different because your head's taller. You're a little bit taller as we're coming into June, and certainly as we leave over the next 6 months, those shoulders are back. Sag, I love this energy in terms of self-confidence for you to be able to come out and shift as well. So whatever your sense of perception of Sagittarius has been at this particular lunar eclipse, I do think it's shifting, and we're going to get to meet a different Sagittarius by the time we close this year. And it is nothing but beautiful, nice changes that were on the way anyway. So now the other thing I do want to tell you energetically, Sag, is if you can ease up your schedule just a little bit around the time of the eclipses, which will be the 5th and the 21st of this month, that's really good, because the eclipse energy coming in such abundance in these perception and value houses can make you a little bit tired. So if you can ease it up, give yourself a break, that's all the good, okay? On the 18th, we see Mercury actually taking this retrograde in the energy of Cancer all the way until July 12th. Now, in the energy of Cancer, this is the 8th house. Because it's Cancerian energy, in the 8th house, which is joint resources, intimacy, sex, trauma, healing, everything to do with astrology, occult, and metaphysical things for sure. But because it's in the energy of Cancer, what I think here is the question for you during this retrograde will be, what are you doing to make sure that you feel secure in your intimate relationships. Now, this can also be intimate relationships is not just sex, it's not just romance, but are you intimately and honestly connected to your money, to your finances, to your healing, to other people, right? There's an interesting independence that needs to happen for interdependence when we have this in the eighth house. So as Mercury is retrograding, I think you're very much so connected at an emotionally intelligent level, right? To, am I secure in this area of my life? Even truly, are those taxes paid? Is the estate planning taken care of? Is there something connected to a will or an inheritance that needs your attention? You may be redoing, re-going over those things. I think too, man, Venus is still retrograde at this point in the month. There could definitely be an old flame trying to come back in. It's Cancer energy. Maybe an old flame is trying to come back to your house. Or maybe there's an old flame coming back for like a parent or a sibling, or you're moving back home, something like that. It's very Cancerian energy that is tapped into this. So whatever it is, you will spend your Mercury retrograde going back over, reviewing, revising, reconnecting, reuniting with these energies. And again, it's about kicking them back into the correct flow of things so that you know that you are secure, Cancer energy, in this area of your life. Now, on the 20th, to help you get that done, the sun moves into the energy of Cancer and we welcome in a new season. Summer here in the north, and we're going to welcome in winter down in the south. So whichever season you're coming into, it's new. I don't know that we really feel the impact of this new season until we get closer to July, because we've got 60% of our planets in retrograde. So we're kind of in the slow. It's like, oh, you know, is it June like 97th? You know, it's just kind of a long month. But the sun will help you be motivated to make changes in this eighth house area. And then just a day later, we welcome in a new moon solar eclipse, which helps you plant these seeds of intention to really kickstart this next 6 months. But because this particular solar eclipse is happening at 0 degrees of Cancer, it is still connected to something else you were already working on. I actually feel like in this particular area, you have enough clarity to truly end and bring to culmination something that you've been working on since about 2018. And now as you get right here, it's like, okay, I see it coming to its culmination. At 0 degrees of Cancer, it also tells us something important and significant is beginning here for you at this particular point in the cycle. And it's lunar, so we also know that it has to do with your emotional life, right? Our emotional life is a part of that thing that helps us stand tall, helps us have that internal psychological secure foundation that we stand on. So you'll definitely be experiencing a lot of that, and these planets are motivated to help you do so. On the 23rd, Neptune is going to head into retrograde in the energy of Pisces and stay that way all the way until November. Now, Pisces energy and Neptune energy, Neptune rules Pisces, so they're very comfortable and happy working together, but this lights up your fourth house space, home, family, real estate, property, but also that internal psychological foundation. But for you, Sag, also, I'm also seeing home here is a connection to maybe a parent or a family member. And what I think is happening for them, it looks like they're needing to make a financial shift. They're shifting or changing financially. So if this is the parent figure or someone in your life, please put that in the comment section down below so that I know that's you. But there could be a shift for family members here as well. But the other part of Neptune retrograde is that when Neptune is forward and direct, it's kind of, we have this place where we can kind of tap out and daydream a little bit. You know what I mean? It's a nice little break from reality sometimes. But when Neptune goes retrograde, it's like, boom, solid reality. It is very, very concrete, which honestly makes our reality seem a little bit distorted because we don't have any place but concrete to go to. So you may have a little bit of confusion in this particular area in this first, I think, month of Neptune being here. So you don't have to make any huge decisions at this particular time. Instead, what Neptune is doing in this retrograde in this area is saying, okay, Sag, let's create our ideal home, which is the physical home that you live in, the location that you live in, and home here. How do you create home here? What makes you feel safe? What makes you feel loved? Where are you giving yourself compassion in the first home that you have, which is here? Neptune says, let's create the ideal of what that looks like so that in November, that can materialize into something that you can actually use, stand on, move into, right? And the example I always use here, you guys, is that it's a chair, right? But before this chair was a chair, it was just an idea. So you are literally getting Neptune's help to go back over this area in retrograde and clean up, clear out, and revision this area of your life for who you'd like to be forward. Don't think for 2 seconds that who you are walking around as on the outside did not start as your vision first, because it most certainly did. All right, on the 25th, we've got Venus, who's back in bounds at this point, coming out of retrograde in the energy of Gemini. Now, it's 5 degrees of Gemini. Now, this lights up across the street for you, right? The relationship house. So, oh, Sag, relationships, you've been evaluating them since May 13th. What's the value of this relationship? What's the financial value of this relationship? Where am I at? Where is the full value of the relationships in my life? And I do still think the first one you've been evaluating is the relationship of you with you. If you're changing, Sag, if you're coming out in a different way, this is the first relationship you've got to evaluate, right? Now, the other things that could have happened during the retrograde is maybe somebody did come back into your life, or maybe a job opportunity or a value opportunity, an opportunity to share your creative talents came back into your life. And now, as Venus is out of retrograde, great here in the seventh house, you can take those things forward and see what has the sticking and staying power, or you can make any adjustments that you saw needed to be made during this retrograde time. Venus was 40 days of Sag, what has value for you? Sag, where are you giving your value? Where are you speaking, Gemini, your value? What's the value in what you're thinking in your relationships? What's the value of your perception in relationship to things, even in the world and in your life, Sag? So now as Venus is out of retrograde, full steam ahead. Let's go. Let's do it. Let's make these changes. Let's bring this love into our life. Let's bring this beautiful writing that has value into our lives. Let's just share your information because it has value, Sag, okay? On the 28th, we see Mars moving into the energy of Aries, where he is happy, he is comfortable, he is ready to do the thing, all right? Now, this is going to light up your fifth house, and I love this for you this month, because Mars is action, energy, assertion, movement, my desire. In the fifth house, this is the house of joy. Joy, play, children, self-expression. This is where we take a risk a little bit, right? And nothing happens without taking a little bit of a risk, even romance, even having children, even creating that business that you want. How about that hobby that you just love? There's a little bit of risk in that, right? Now, I love this too, because this is an energy of Aries. Aries trusts their instincts. So trust your instincts here. You are a fellow fire sign, Sagittarius. Trust your instincts in this particular area of your life. Does it feel like the right timing to take on this whatever? Does it feel like the right timing to take a leap in this particular area of your life? Now, I will tell you too, Mars is Mars and Aries is Aries. So if there is a fight, if there is a conflict, if there is assertion or aggression that needs to come to your table in this particular area, it's going to happen. It will come up, but it will come up so that you can move things forward. The idea is always, it's a cosmic conspiracy to help you stay in the flow, but that doesn't mean that we always get there super peacefully, right? So in your fifth house area, could the kids be fighting a little bit more? Could you feel like you're actually fighting for your expression or fighting for joy and you're putting it out there, right? This could definitely be an experience of this energy this month. And I do think too, if you wanted to try and start a business, try to start something that you enjoy, maybe put in even adoption or fostering papers, something like that, you could do that at this particular time. Now, as we close out the month, we're going to see Jupiter, your ruling planet, who is retrograde, coming into a conjunction, the second of three that it will have this year, with Pluto, who's also in retrograde. Now, as these two came together in April, what happened is in your second house, the house of value, self-esteem, money, your possessions, the things that how you value and how you're important to yourself, right? As these two came together in April, they are supercharged. It's power, it's desire meets focus. And the idea here is success, but it shows you why you've got to release something. What's the wisdom of releasing something so that something else can evolve, right? Now in April, they came together in your second house. So whether this was an actual financial situation or this had to do with possessions or self-esteem, you started something there. You got on the track, whether you consciously can acknowledge it or not. look around your life. Something started here in April. Now, whatever started in that area, as they come together again in this particular conjunction, they're both retrograde. So they're like, let's go over that. Let's review that. Let's like clean that up a little. Let's see what we need to do to zhuzh it up and get it back on track, right? But what they also do when they come together here is it's a deeper energy where it shows you, Sag, you have an immense capacity and capability to efficiently and effectively, successfully surmount the challenges that come up in front of you, right? The second house is such a big house where your self-confidence matters a lot in this particular area. So I think that this energy is also going back over that for you and saying, Sag, we're a little bit different now. Let's put these shoulders back over this next handful of months and get ready to shine with our chests out, right? It's very shine with that big heart out, but also to put some structure around our money, put some structure around our possessions, put some structure around the skills and talents we have to offer the world. And if you find the stumbling blocks, these energies are an astrological success combo to help you know that you can succumb those things. Ah, busy, beautiful month. Try and give yourself a rest where you can. Trust your instincts, trust your intuition on your own energies and actions this month. And man, I look forward to seeing how the month comes out for you, okay? Lots of friends coming over to the Cyber House for the eat and greets. I hope you guys are enjoying them. Lots of different topics. We're bringing techniques to you. So keep watching the community tab, Facebook, Instagram, wherever you follow me. I'll keep putting up our visitors there and we are loving coming to share with you. So hopefully you guys are getting a lot out of it as well. All right, Sag, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I love you a ton, and I look forward to seeing you next month. Bye.